Hi everyone, how's it going? Welcome to Quick Learn, and for today's video, I'll be showing you how to set up payment options on WooCommerce. Now, without further ado, let's get started. First, open up your computer browser and head on to the WordPress website. Now, I know what you are thinking, like, hey, why are you going to the WordPress when we are setting up our WooCommerce? Now, WooCommerce is actually an extension or actually an application on WordPress. Now, in order for you to have a WooCommerce, you must actually have a WordPress account. Now, just sign up using WordPress. Now, just enter your email address, your valid password, so you can now go to WordPress. And once you're in WordPress, you can now access WooCommerce. Now, on this left section right here, as you can see, this is the WooCommerce. So all I have to do is click on WooCommerce, and it will lead me to the homepage of WooCommerce right about here. So this is the homepage of WooCommerce right about here. So as you can see, I still haven't set up my store. Now, basically, for this video, I will show you how to set up payment options. Now, in order for you to do that, you must actually go to payments right here under the WooCommerce right here. Just hit on payments. And for now, we have WooCommerce payments. So this is the recommended application for you to use in order for you to have payments. Like, you can receive payments. You can actually receive payments if you have the WooCommerce payments application. So in order for you to do that, you must click on finish setup right here and just click on continue. So it will lead you to this next page right here. As you can see, this is the WooCommerce payments page. So get paid by WooCommerce payments. So fill out a few details so you can start getting paid. So this is powered by Stripe. So this is very legit. So just enter the email address of your WordPress and click on continue. So once you have do that, just enter the password that you have and click on log in. And now all we need to do is to enter our mobile number. So let's just select where we are currently at right now. I'm the Philippines, so enter the phone number you have and hit on continue. So enter the verification code right now. As you can see, WooCommerce payments is sending our verification code, and now just hit on your phone right there. And let's just wait for the PIN, and there you have it. I already received my PIN on my phone right here. And there you have it. So once we are done, it says tell us about your business. So just head on to the country where your business is currently located. So for now, I'm gonna use United States right here and type of business. So you can have individual business, company business, or nonprofit organization. So I'm just gonna select individual right here and I'm gonna head on to continue. And next, once you are done, you have done with that, it'll lead you to this page right here. It is still processing, so we'll just wait for a minute. And as you can see right here, we need to verify our personal details. So enter your name, of course, your last name, your email address, and enter your birth date right about there. And now enter your home address. Let's just say Los Angeles. Now enter your phone number right about there, and for now I can't enter the phone number because WooCommerce is not actually available in my country. So once you enter your phone number, you need to enter your postal address right here or postal code and enter your phone number, and lastly enter the 4-digit of your social security number. So if you have done that, just click on continue right here and it will lead you to this another page right here. And now once you have done that, we are now ready to access WooCommerce payments. So let me just go back to my WordPress right about here, and I'm gonna enter to WooCommerce. So right here. So as you can see, we are now in our WooCommerce homepage, and we have just entered our payment details. So next is, you can now actually have some account details right here. So you just click on edit details right about here to actually enable the payments and deposits. So as you can see right here, it will lead me to the Stripe Express. And now once we are done with that, we can actually set your payouts are paused. Now to resume payouts for WooCommerce, update your payment details. So I'm just gonna click on update information right here, and we need to have our WooCommerce payments updated right about here. So all you have to do is to add an account right here. So you have the option to whether or not to add a bank account or a debit card account. So it's all up to you. So once you have done that, just click on save right here, and now you're good. And now you are good to go, and now you can receive payments using the bank account that you have connected, and all of those payments will actually go into your bank account that or debit card that you've actually connected into WooCommerce payments. So next is link external accounts. So these are financial accounts are sometimes required to enable certain features and payments methods. So if you want to do that, just click on this one right here, and you have the option whether or not to add a link account. So just refresh this if no link accounts are connected. So in order for you to connect a link account, all you have to do is set up right about there, and then you're about good to go. And next is the platform settings. So view and edit information that Stripe needs about how you earn money with platforms. So this is very important right here, because Stripe needs to know how you earn money with the platform right here. So just click on the information needed. So as you can see right here, these are the details or what are you actually selling in WooCommerce. So just add some services right here if you want. So just click on add right here, just click on continue. And then once you have done that, you can now actually enter some of your professional details. You can actually enter some of your public details right here. So for example, under professional details, you can actually select missing required business information. So you can actually add your business information so that they will know, so that WooCommerce knows what are you actually selling, and they can help you how you can earn money. So just click on edit right here. So for example, I'm into, let's just say, clothing and accessories. So just enter your website just right about there. If you have a website, you can enter your Shopify website or any website that you actually have. And now just click on next right here, and now on the product description, you can actually say that I am selling clothing and accessories right about there. So just simply describe your business right about there. So once you are done with that, just click on save right here, and now it will be saved automatically. And now next is the public details, so missing customer support information. So if you have a support information about customers, you can actually do that as well. So just click on edit, and now you can enter the customer support phone number that you actually have. So once you're done with that, you can actually set them some personal details information. So just click on update right here, and as you can see, these are the you can enter your name, your email address, the date of birth, your home address, your phone number, and the last four digits of your social security number. So once you have done with that, you can click on submit. And as you can see, once we are done setting up all of this, you can now actually set up or receive payments using WooCommerce. So that's it for this video, and I hope you find this video helpful. And if you have some questions, some comments, or even some suggestions, just feel free to comment it down in the comment section below. So that's it for this video, and I hope you find this helpful, and if you do, please don't forget to give this video a like, subscribe to this channel, and of course, click on that notification bell to be notified for future videos. Bye!